Imagine if you could split your meeting into groups. Perhaps you want to organize a brainstorming session or group exercises. In today's video, I'm going to show you how with breakout rooms in Microsoft Teams. Now, before I jump into the content, there is a few things that you need to keep in mind. Only the meeting organizer can set up the breakout rooms. And they can only do this on the desktop version of Microsoft Teams. Participants, they can join from anywhere, so they can join via the web version, mobile version, and the desktop version. So here I am in a meeting that I joined earlier. Now, if my meeting screen looks different to yours, that's because I'm using the new meeting experience. And you will need to enable this before you can use breakout rooms. To enable this feature, just go to your profile, click settings, and you want to check this box here. It does require a restart, so just sign out and then sign back in again. You won't be able to assign people to the breakout rooms until they have joined the meeting. Currently, I have two other people on this call. When it comes to this channel, Ready Steady XL is a one-man show, and I've only got a limited amount of devices. But in real life, you're likely to have more users when working with breakout rooms. The breakout rooms feature is this little icon here, the one with the two squares. When I click on here, I get this screen. The first question, how many rooms do I need? And if I click on the number, I can create up to 50 rooms. For this example, I'm going to go for two. And when I click on two, here it shows me how many people will be assigned into the rooms. So because I've got a limited amount of participants, at the moment it's only doing one per room. Next, I've got two options. I can either get Teams to create these rooms automatically and Teams will randomly assign the people to the rooms, or I can do it manually myself. In this example, I'm going to go for the automatic option, but I can manually move people around the different rooms if I need to. So let's click Create Rooms. Microsoft Teams is now working its magic. And here on the right, we've got two rooms. So we've got room one and we've got room two. So here's a latecomer to this meeting, Ron Burgundy, and he's currently not assigned to a room. So I can do this now. So if I hover here, expand, click on Ron's name, click assign, and it will come up with the rooms. And I then click on the room that I want to pop him into. Now, if a lot more people joined, I do have the option here to add more rooms if I needed to. Just simply click in Add Room and it will add another room. If you want to move people to a different room, just expand the room, select their name, click Assign, and then choose the room. So it's as simple as that. Now, before I start up these breakout rooms, I just want to show you some of the settings that are available. So if I click here, More Options. So we've got Room Settings. And the first option is a default setting, so people will be moved over automatically when the rooms are opened. And you've also got a checkbox here to allow people to move back to the main room when they're ready. So I'm going to tick on this box just to give people a bit of freedom. So at the moment, we're all in this main room. So to start the breakout rooms, you just simply click Start Rooms. Everyone will get a message to say that they will be moved over in 10 seconds. And off they go. Ron Burgundy's the last one, always the last one to go. And he's now gone to his room. So here I am in the main room, all by myself. Now, if I want to go into these rooms myself, just to check on how people are doing, so maybe they're having a discussion, doing a bit of brainstorming, going through an exercise, then I can jump into those rooms and check how people are doing. So to do that, I just click here, hover the mouse over the room, click More Options, and I've got the option to join a room. Whilst I'm here, just to show you, you've also got options to rename the room. So if I didn't want it to be called Room 1, maybe I want it to be called Group A, then I could rename it. By clicking Close Room, it will just bring this room here back into the main area. I'm not ready to do that just yet, so I'm going to click Join Room, and it opens this window here, and I'm now in the room with T. Leskoski, so Thomas Leskoski, and Ron Burgundy. So here I could discuss to see how they're all doing. And then when I'm finished with this room, I click Return, and it brings me back to the main room. And if I wanted to jump into Room 2, it's the same process. I just click More Options and then click Join Room. Now, if I wanted to send a message across all the rooms, then I could do that without jumping into each room. So to do that, we go up to More Options and I click Make an Announcement. So this allows me to broadcast a message across all the rooms. So perhaps I want to give people a 5-minute warning. And when I click send, this will broadcast an important message to each room. If needed, people can then respond to that message. So as you can see here, I've got the response and I can choose to click reply. And just to show you where those messages go, if I minimize this, and if I click here on chat, I've got my rooms here. If I click on room one, I can see the response. And if I wanted to send further messages, then I could do it from here too. So to bring everyone back to the main room here, you just simply click close rooms, and this will start to bring everyone back to this main room. So once everyone's returned to the main room, I mean, you can see them there on the screen there, but you could also go to participants to see them listed. And at any point, if you want to restart those rooms, maybe you've given them another exercise, you could click start rooms. Or if you wanted to recreate the rooms, it's just a matter of going to more options, click recreate rooms, click recreate, and then you can restart the process. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Teams, then watch these videos here, and I will see you in the next video.